If you're watching this video on a Tuesday, happy Mars Day. Not Veronica, but the planet named after the Roman God of War. We're gonna edit this in post and make me sound cool, right? Hey, it's Nas from Naztronomy. If you didn't already know, Mars will be in opposition on December 8th, 2022. And before that time comes, I wanted to spend some time to get some practice in case I get clear skies at or near opposition. In this video, I'll go over my acquisition details of my practice run. I'll save the processing steps for the opposition image if I get to take one. Last time I attempted to image Mars at opposition was 2014, and this is the results. Not too bad considering that it was just a single frame taken with a DSLR at my 6SE and a 2X Barlow. And I was able to get some practice in on Mars over the summer, and this is the result that I got. I used the exact same setup, and although you can see some more features on Mars, it wasn't what I wanted and I wasn't really happy with it. I normally take planetary images with my DSLR because it's easy to move around with just the only wire being my intervalometer. But I really wanted to try out my ZWO-533MC Pro AstroCam and see if it made a difference, and boy, did it make a difference. In my backyard, I set up my Nexstar 6SE, my AVX mount, Teleview 3X Barlow, and AstroCam, all connected to a laptop running FireCapture. I had an effective focal length of 4,500 millimeters at f30, and you can imagine that it took a little while to find, center, and focus on Mars. Since I was so zoomed in. And when I got the framing right, I shot this 2-minute 13-second video of Mars at 6 FPS. The laptop I used was struggling a little bit, so 6 FPS was the best that it can do at that time. Once I processed the video in PIPP and AutoStakkert, I started to see some color and some surface features, and that got me really excited. This alone was better than my previous best shot. But of course, I needed to work on the wavelets. For this, I used two different methods. The first method was my usual Registax, and my second method was Astrosurface, which was recommended to me by a fellow astronomer named Martin Schoenmaker. Link to his channel in the description below. This is the shot I got through Registax wavelets, and it looks really good. I can see some of the polarized caps. I can see some features on Mars very clearly. I couldn't get it as sharp as I wanted, but this is really good. This is much better than what I've done in the past. And of course, Astrosurface blew my mind. It was my third or fourth time using it, and this is the resulting image from Astrosurface. I was able to get more color out of the planet. You can see some of the features a little bit more clearly, and it is the best shot I've taken of the red planet. Here's a comparison between Registax and Astrosurface. You can see the color differences, and I think it's a little bit sharper as well. I didn't do any kind of processing outside of the application that I mentioned. So this session got me really excited about opposition. I'm crossing my fingers for clear sky so that I can image it at or at least near opposition using the same gear that I used for my practice run. So subscribe, come back, and see what I catch. And if you try it, I wish you luck as well. Clear skies.